May God's blessing be upon us. And may God protect us from the enemy that would try to steal this word from us. In Christ's name. We come to the conclusion of our series on the book of Jonah. The series on the stages of death and dying, as the stages of grief, as they have become known over the years. And we come to this stage of acceptance, having moved through denial, anger, bargaining, and depression. This place of acceptance. And over the week, as I was thinking about this sermon and what it means, even the word accept, and there's so many different ways you can take that word, there's so many different ways you can hold it. I kind of thought of three different ways that we can think about this word acceptance that really fit Jonah's story, and it really fits a lot of the ways we deal with life and how we deal with our own faith walk. And that faith walk is really important for us to think about at all times, but certainly during this season of Lent, where we're taking our walk, we're making our journey towards the cross of Jesus Christ, which will take us to the tomb, which will bring us to the glorious resurrection. So, what this word accept, and the first thing I started to think about is that before we even get into the clinical one that we're talking about with the stages of grief, this idea of that which is acceptable. That which is acceptable in our house when one of the children does something that they're not supposed to be doing or it's out of line or out of turn, generally we tell them that's unacceptable. That's kind of our terminology. That's simply unacceptable. That has gone over the line of what we allow. And a lot of times we think about that which is acceptable about the parameters of how we live our lives. If we're talking about what's acceptable and unacceptable, we're certainly not talking about excellence at that point. If we're talking about excellence and we just fell short of it, or that was pretty good. If we're an unacceptable, if we're trying to just hit that spot right there, we're kind of walking a thin line of what's acceptable. Just trying to make it by. Just doing enough. I read all these stories about how food is taken care of in our food chain and food supply in our country and the parameters of that which is healthy and unhealthy. And I'm always amazed at what's acceptable in our foods. Pesticides and bugs and the parts per million they talk about of all this stuff. The parts per million, some of them are very acceptable within those things that we eat and take care of. It seems kind of odd. So it's not always excellence. It's just that's acceptable. We have to allow for that to happen. So acceptable is doing just enough. And Jonah was pretty good in this story of his life, of his prophecy, of doing almost enough to be acceptable. But when he didn't, it was just unacceptable. He was always just kind of walking that line, staying pretty close to where he was supposed to be. I don't want to go, God. God says that's unacceptable. I will go, God. He spit out onto the shores of Nineveh. I don't want to tell him, God. You will tell him. He's always right on that line of acceptability in God's eyes. And again, one of the things I like about Jonah is that Jonah is a good tale for all of us. It's a good story for all of us to hold on to, because so often we want to know, what do I have to do to be acceptable in the community of faith? What do I have to do to be acceptable in my discipleship? So much of what we think about is, what's the amount I have to do to get by? And Jonah kind of lived his life that way, especially, again, in this recounting of this story of his life, of this prophecy he was taking, just doing enough. And when we just do enough, we're always on the verge of not doing enough. We're always just trying to get by. We're always going to be just about to fall short. And we see that with Jonah. He was always doing almost acceptable and almost falling short, even at the end. Thank God for the tree. I pity the tree. I should do well to die. He's always just living on the edge of acceptability, of that which is decent, that which is allowed. And we see how it works out for Jonah, but we also know how that kind of life works out for us, because maybe we're not living it right now, or even today, or this moment, but we know we can look back on our lives and we can see those times where we lived just to do enough. Maybe it's not even with the church, maybe it's just with the schoolwork, with our family work, with our jobs, with relationships, doing just enough to get by. And we see what the struggle is with that. We see a struggle when we're just doing just enough to get by, and Jonah lives it out. And we see for Jonah how it ends. For Jonah, it ends with him still being angry, still being displeased, still falling short of God's call on his life, but just falling short on living a life of any kind of comfort for himself. He's not just displeased and angry. He's uncomfortable at the end of his story. He would rather die than to live. So acceptability is not a goal for Jonah. Acceptability should not be a goal for those of us who call ourselves disciples. Just to be accepted, to just do enough. So that's one way of looking at this word, accept, in Jonah. And I think it's helpful for us to see it that way, because as we review and kind of move on from Jonah, that we don't want to live that way, because we see how it leaves us. Then there's the more clinical definition, the one that we've been working on through these stages of grief, these stages of death and dying, acceptance. And in the stages of death and grief and death and the stages of grief and death and dying, as Google Ross points them out, acceptance is that part for the terminal patient after they've gone kind of through these other stages, through denial and anger and bargaining and through depression. They get to this stage of acceptance. And acceptance isn't a place of quiet joy and quiet rest. It's more a place of resignation. Oh, this is really going to happen to me. This is really the way it's going to be. This disease that I have is going to take my life in the foreseeable future. In 3 days, 6 months, a year, I'm no longer going to be here. It's not a terrible place. But it's not accepting and going, yay, well, the Lord loves me and he's going to bring me home. That's a place of hope that comes after all of these stages. It's a place of saying, oh, this is where I am. This is what's happened. And now I need to, having accepted this, I need to organize my life. I need to organize my life in a particular way. To take this final journey, to make these final walks. For the disciples with Jesus, at some point they came to that moment of acceptance. Some of them probably came earlier than others. I expect we don't hear about the exact opinions and thoughts of all the disciples during Holy Week, from the Last Supper, even on through. But I expect some of them kind of figured it out early and said, this isn't going to end the way I wanted it to, so I accept it. I accept where it is. For some of them, the acceptance came not before the cross, not even during the tomb or after the resurrection, but sometime later. You find that place of saying, wow, this isn't what I expected, but this is where I am. A place of being resigned to, I can't fix this, I can't change this, and this is where we are. Jonah is pretty much there by the end of the book. He accepts it. He accepts it, that God's in charge, that God's in control, that if God calls Jonah to go somewhere, that Jonah's going to end up being there. And if God wants a cool wind to come, it would come. And if God wants a sultry wind to come, it's going to come. and that Jonah has no control over. If God wants Jonah to go to the Ninevites and share good news with bad people, he'll go there. And if God wants to send Jonah to good people to share good news, he'll have to go there. He's in a place of acceptance. His response to the acceptance is, I'd rather die than live. But it is a place of acceptance, a place resigned to where he is. It's a sad place. You're reading Jonah. We don't read Jonah and finish it and go, wow, that was a good one. I'm glad it turned out that way. We don't do that. That's why it's a pretty good book for Lent, because Lent's kind of that way, because Lent takes us up to the cross. Up to the cross. And it leaves us literally, figuratively, metaphorically hanging, just as Jesus was. It leaves us there. Well, what do we do now? What do we do now? Here we have Jonah, who's left in pain and agony and distress, mostly of his own making, but not knowing what to do. But he's also in a place where he's saying, this is just where I am. This is where I must have to stay. And I have no place out of this. He tried to do what was acceptable only. He comes to a place of acceptance. But I think most importantly, the word accept for us. And Jonah doesn't really point to this at all in the book. But it leaves us at a place where we can see where we need to go. And that's the place of knowing that you are accepted. You are accepted. That you are loved. That you are cared for. That you have not been left alone. That God loves you. The idea of being accepted by God, by God's love and by God's grace, is not to be to do just what was allowed, or even God just to say, you've done just enough to get into my good graces, or you've done just enough to be kept out of my good graces. God doesn't act that way. God says, you are accepted. And in that moment, we are consumed, overwhelmed, and really feel ourselves embraced by God's love. Not at all because of what we have done or left undone. That's where Jonah was missing the whole thing. He missed it all. It's not because of what we've done or what we have left undone. It's because of what God is doing, has done for us, is doing for us, and will do for us for all eternity. We are accepted because of God's action. Jonah never came to that understanding that the people of Nineveh were loved by God, even though they were terrible, awful, horrible people. God still loved them. God wanted what was best for them. God wanted them to turn and to repent and was willing to send his, obviously, the best prophet he had for the day to go and tell them this news. God loved them. God didn't just love Nineveh, he loved all creation. As we find out in Jonah, because there's a lot of people in Nineveh, the scripture tells us, and also a whole bunch of cattle. You want me to just destroy all that too? No, because my love extends beyond you, Jonah. My love extends beyond what your understanding and where your understanding of love should go. Jonah was never able to get to that point. At least not in the story we read, at least not in the book of Jonah as we see it. We can see where he was able to and willing to do that which was acceptable to a point. We can see where it comes to a point of acceptance to say, this is where it must be, and this is where my life might end, and this is just how the world works, and I may not like it. But that's no place for us to live as God's people. Doing that which is acceptable, or just accepting it for what it is. We are called to that next step. A next step beyond the stages of grief, beyond the stages of death and dying. Because we know how this story ends. We even know how the Lenten story ends. It's not a story that ends in death, it's a story that ends in resurrection. Though we walk the stations of the cross, we know that the stations of the cross are not how the story ends. The story ends on Easter Sunday morning, when death is overcome, where death has no strength, where Jesus has the final victory. And in that victory, he has that victory not because we finally got it right and we did what we were supposed to do. Quite the contrary. We have that victory because God loves us so much and he wants us to know beyond any shadow of a doubt that we are accepted, that we are loved, and his grace abounds. His grace is good enough. His grace is big enough. Even when we're missing it, even when we don't see it, it was big enough for Jonah even when he missed it. It was big enough for Nineveh even when they didn't know what it meant to see God's grace. God's grace is there for us. And I pray for us as a church, I pray for us as individuals, I pray for us as a community, I pray for our world that we will see that God loves us so much and that we will hear those words one day ringing in our hearts and in our heads, and we will hear ourselves saying, yes, Lord, I am accepted. I am accepted by you and loved by you, and that you are making me right. And you are making me whole. And that we will not be left like Jonah, just in the resignation of acceptance, but in the joy of being accepted by God. Accepted by God. And loved by God. And full of God's grace in our lives. You are accepted. You are accepted. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.